The new media art nowadays are start to gaining more space in the exhibition in general. So there is an important necessity for new media artists to be able to show this work in a more easy way. Most of the times, there is a time that occurs the performance, and then when it's finished, they can transport to another place. So it's not about the documentation, it's not the same as the traditional documentation of art. So this takes a limit of time sometimes, or a limited of time, and sometimes the objects is not more about showing the object, it's now more about showing, using the objects to make people interact. The people can be different, the people can interact in a different way. And all these way of using the space are the new behaviors that this project is involved in this research to find and to explore about showing a space and see how artists can connect and can also improve their work and promote their work through their architecture. The project links art, technology, architecture, all in the axis of the digital art.
Artists that are very creative, they can develop their own ideas by using digital fabrication to organize performances or to organize spaces where other artists can play.
There are different lines of research that are involved in the theoretical framework from the project, from the new concepts of the architecture in the digital age, the exhibition as the new media art is involved, also the support of the sustainable industry, so the way how the new technologies can make the architecture produce more impact in the emerging artists. Many different participants are involved in this cycle of working. The first step was making interviews for artists. And through these interviews, I analyze and detect the exactly necessities that would be the variables of functions, the typologies, and all the requirements that are going to be involved in this. It's important that the artists for this project, they can do it by themselves. It means that they can have the opportunity to be involved in the design, in this process. I made this through the workshop, participatory workshop of design with artists, where they start to add in different necessities and different comments. And this was an important process that change and add things in the design. There were also many details about the assemble and dissemble concepts that I apply. I'm using the CNC machine for the whole fabrication of the models, and this is easy for any people, any user, any artist can fabricate it by themselves, can assemble by themselves, so it is easy to transport and to be replicable. The can display is a transportable structure that can be replicated and easy to fabricate and to install anywhere. So with this idea is to facilitate this for artists, to give a reason for them to see their work in another context.
I think it is very important for the artists and for everyone to go through this process of assembling the model, because I think it's nice to understand how things are made, how other disciplines work. So I think it's good that as an artist, see how the space where your project is going to be, how it is fabricated, assembling. So I think it's nice to have this, to be part and engaged, to be part of it.
Plug-on display for me is innovative.
It's a simple intervention with a great impact.
I feel this makes it open and collaborative with artists and the users that are going to use this space, the visitors and architects also are involved.
Creo porque al final sí, o sea, yo creo que es importante que la gente que va a utilizar este proyecto sea parte del proceso creativo, proceso de desarrollo, porque creo que es muy importante el ir testeando a medida que vas desarrollando.
Creo que es importante que los artistas, o sea, bueno, que en este caso Cristina, que es la, pues, la arquitecta que ha hecho los módulos, y nosotros los artistas que somos los que vamos a usar, es importante, yo creo, que estemos desde el principio para ver cuáles son las posibilidades, cuáles son los errores, cómo se puede mejorar, cuál es el uso que le podemos dar, ¿no? Creo que es importante que haya a lo mejor no un 50% cada uno, pero mucha parte de cada, para que al final se llegue al objetivo, ¿no? Que sea.
Plug and Display me evoca eso, ¿no? El poner y hacer, y como muy rápido, muy accesible, muy barato también, como muy útil y práctico.
Soportes positivos son dos, pero ¿soporte?
Variabilidad o algo así, modularidad.
Entiendo que es como algo como fácil de armar, de montar.
Posibilidades.
Transformación.